So we're going to continue our discussion of Bhagavad Gita in English. Today's shlokas are really very, very interesting because it will show the special compassion of the Lord towards his devotees. So we're going to discuss that. Somebody can chant after me. Yeah. Bhagavad Gita chapter 1, text number 20. Atha vyavasthitan drishtva
Atha vyavasthitan drishtva
Dhritarashtran kapidhvajah
Dhritarashtran kapidhvajah
Pravritte shastra sampate
Pravritte shastra sampate
Manurudyamya pandavah
Manurudyamya pandavah
Rishikesham tadavakyam
Rishikesham tadavakyam
Idam ahamahipate
Ahamahipate
Ahamahipate नहीं नॉट अहम अहिपते इदम अहम अधिपते
इदम अहम महीपते
यस यू थिंक आई एम नॉट हियरिंग योर चैंटिंग ओके अथ सो वी हैव डिस्कस दैट दैट द फ्रॉम बोथ साइड्स द आर्मीज देयर वाज ब्लोइंग ऑफ कॉन्शल्स एंड पांडवकस एंड लाइक दैट एंड वी हैव आल्सो सीन दैट द पांडवस आर्मीज दे हैड ट्रांसेंडेंटल कॉन्शल्स कृष्णा वाज ऑन देयर साइड एंड बाय द साउंड ऑफ देयर कॉन्शल्स द अदर साइड्स द हार्ट्स वर ब्रोकन So now, atha means now, vyavasthitan drishtva dhatrashtran kapidhvaja, vyavasthitan drishtva, seeing the armies of dhatrashtra, dhatrashtra means the army of the sons of dhatrashtra, very nicely arranged, kapidhvaja means the person whose flag was marked with the sign of Hanumanji. Kapi means monkey. Hanumanji. So Kapidhvaja means flag which is marked with the sign of Hanumanji or Kapi. Pravritte Shastra Sampate. Pravritte means to start. Shastra Sampate. That now the battle has begun and now there will be a release of weapons. Dhanur Uddamya Pandava. Here Pandava refers to Arjuna. Uddamya means, Dhanur means bow, and he raised his bow, he took his had his bow to fight now. So meaning will be, having seen the armies of Dhritarashtra arranged very nicely, Arjuna, whose flag was marked with the sign of Hanumanji, seeing that now the battle is going to begin, the weapons will be released, he took up his weapon of Dhanush. Dhanush means bow. And that Pandava was Arjuna. Then Rishikesham Tada Vakyam. Tada means then. He spoke one sentence to Rishikesh. Means controller of senses. Means Krishna. Idam Aha Mahipate. O Mahipate. Mahipate he refers to Dhritarashtra. Who is the king of the whole earth. O king of the whole earth. Idam Aha. He spoke this. So did you understand the meaning of the words? Am I going too fast? Are you able to catch?
Yes.
Okay. See, you will be becoming more and more familiar with Sanskrit as we just keep on understanding the meanings. And it is expected that you again go back and see, look up at the word meanings, then you can understand further. Okay. You have a book, Pitamar Nimai Prabhu, somewhere, a text. Somebody can use my phone or something. This phone also can be used. TV? Whatever. Okay. Translation. At that time, Arjuna, the son of Pandu, seated in the chariot, bearing the flag marked with Hanuman, took up his bow and prepared to shoot his arrows. O king, after looking at the sons of Dhritarashtra drawn in military array, Arjuna then spoke to Lord Krishna these words. So this is, we have done this. Gita Bhushan 1.20. After the fear among the followers of Dhritarashtra has been described, the enthusiasm of the Pandavas is indicated in a verse and a half, verse 20 and first half of 21. How it is indicated? You see, after seeing that the Dhritarashtras were very eager to fight, he has also taken up his weapon. So he is not fearful, he means Arjuna. So this shows that he also is enthusiastic now to fight. It's natural, isn't it? Two fighters are coming, then he sees that they are raising the weapon, so they also raise the weapon. So they are not fearful. Arjuna saw Bhishma and others standing there with a desire to fight, trying to counteract the defeat of their enthusiasm on hearing the sound of enemy conches. This line you understood? Bhishma Dev had seen that how when the conch shells on the side of Pandavas were blown, Their army had their hridayani vidaryat, their hearts were shattered. So just to encourage their armies, now they're raising their weapons to fight, to show that they are actually now not afraid, they want to fight. So in response to that also, Arjuna is raising his weapon. Arjuna had the flag of Hanuman. This indicates that he had received the mercy of the great warrior Hanuman, who had previously performed great feats for Sri Ram. Therefore, Arjuna had no trace of fear. A beautiful reflection on this. You see, when try to enter that pastime, when the devotees are in a pastime, do they realize that they are in a pastime? I will again repeat this. When the devotees are in a pastime, do they realize that they are in a pastime? Think about it. So the Pandavas, although they are in the pastime of Lord Shri Krishna, but they don't see it as a pastime. They are seeing it as a normal life sequences. Just like Vasudeva is not thinking what is the next step when he's taking Krishna with him to Vrindavan. What is the next in the script? He does not think like this. Are you able to understand this point, what I'm trying to say? Now for Arjuna, Lord Ram's Leela is Leela. And he knows that Hanumanji has participated in that Leela. Are you able to understand my point? But he himself is not seeing that this is pastime of the Lord. For him is a reality. Reality in the sense it's like a normal, it's like our normal life is going on, similar like that. So now you see, Hanumanji has participated in a pastime of the Lord before and is helping the devotee who's participating in the pastime of the Lord now. For us, the 5,000 years back, this was a pastime of the Lord, was a pastime of the Lord. But now also a pastime of the Lord is going on. And do you think that we are participating in the pastime of the Lord? Do you feel like that? And I'm not telling you to encourage you. I already shared in Shastric Inspiration. This pastime of Harinam Sankirtan spreading is a pastime of Sriman Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Prithvi te achayata nagaradigram sarvatra prachar hobe marinam. You know this? Mahaprabhu has predicted it. So this is all the pastimes of the Supreme Lord. And it's amazingly that we are in the pastime. Do you realize, Kunal? Yeah, you may be intellectually saying like that. But what in this world, is still we don't, nobody can really know what ISKCON is doing right now. What kind of activity is doing. And when we go in that direction, the whole thing will open up. But I'm just trying to say, you see, we will go back to Godhead Koral. Yes. Why not? Yes, you will go. You're chanting 16 rounds. It's not an ordinary thing which is happening now to people. People are getting connected. Somehow they're now joining ISKCON. And everybody who sincerely practices Krishna consciousness, everybody will vouch for it that his life has been completely transformed. Completely. Even people who are objecting him, they also say, "Yar, tu badal gaya yar. Bilkul, you have completely transformed." This transformation you have not seen, you could have not even conceived of this kind of transformation in your own consciousness before you come into Krishna consciousness. So why I say all those things, just like Arjuna was helped by Hanumanji, similarly sincere devotees will be helped by the mercy and blessings of previous acharyas. Just like one of the Alvars had said this. I think it is Nam Alvar, but I may be wrong. But name I don't know, but one of the Alvars have said this. I can see the devotees chanting Hare Krishna Mantra, Hari Nam on the streets. And I give all my blessings to them. Way back, hundreds of years back, he has seen all of us. And you know that Prabhupada was saying how people were, the militias were dancing and Naraji and Shivji were there and they were laughing at them. So don't think that this pastime is not going on and somehow there we are in the pastime. Normal people given with an extraordinary, in ordinary people given with an extraordinary process of Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. So we should be desiring this point that we let me somehow or in some way participate in this pastime of Mahaprabhu by spreading the Hare Krishna mantra. Okay, I just was sharing my reflection on this. So that Arjuna had no trace of fear. So Arjuna had a role to play in Mahabharata. We have a role to play in चैतन्य लीला. ओ किंग महीपते लॉर्ड ऑफ द अर्थ एज द बैटल वॉज अबाउट टू बिगिन प्रवृत्ते अर्जुन स्पोक दोज वर्ड्स टू कृष्णा ऋषिकेश वन हु सेट्स द सेंसेस इन मोशन. दिस यू अंडरस्टैंड ऋषिकेश मीन्स कंट्रोलर ऑफ द सेंसेस. This indicates that there is no doubt about victory for the pure devotees, the Pandavas, for whom the Lord of all being Hari had great attachment. Why? This is very simple to understand. Krishna will control the senses of not only the Pandavas, but he will control the senses of Kauravas also. In a way, so that the victory is ultimately given to the Pandavas. I give an example. After the end of battle of Kurukshetra, Pandavas were told, by Krishna, let us sleep outside today. You know that? Tonight, let us sleep outside. So they were told by Krishna particularly to sleep outside. On that night, Ashwatthama had come and then he kills, instead of killing Pandavas, he kills the sons of Pandavas. So like that, and if you know, if you scrutinizingly study the battle of Kurukshetra, you will see how at every step Krishna is is inspiring, controlling like that. A very small example, you know that pastime, famous pastime, I like it so much, that Karna was fighting with Arjuna. You know this pastime, but it is always nice to remember it. And when Arjuna and Krishna were not allowing Indra were allowing Agni to devour the Khanda forest, you know that pastime. So one very poisonous snake had sneaked in from the forest. You know that? And that, no, not Takshak, but some name, and was very, very poisonous. And that snake, in the subtle form, has entered one of the arrows of Karna. And he was inspiring in a subtle way to Karna that you should use this bow. You should use this bow. So Karna also was not very conscious why he's being inspired to do like this. So he took out that bow, and if it would have touched Arjuna a little bit, Arjuna would have died. So now Krishna knows that. Krishna knows everything. So Karna is releasing this arrow. Now, as he released the arrow, it was supposed to hit the forehead of Arjuna. But Krishna became so heavy, he just put his feet on the Ratha chariot like this. So it was so forceful that the horses, they bent down. So then because of this, the head of Arjuna was lowered, and that arrow hit the helmet of Arjuna. So like this. So you see how Krishna was controlling, how much Krishna was constantly in anxiety, not anxiety, but he was constantly worrying, or not worrying also, he was constantly thinking how to protect my devotees, because those devotees have taken up the cause of Lord Krishna. Today's we learn so many things about Krishna and his devotees. Mahipate, O king, refers to Dhritarashtra. He was the king of the whole world at that time. Arjuna then spoke. Note, this is a very interesting story. Please hear. Very nice, very sweet story between Hanumanji and Arjuna. When Arjuna went to Rameshwaram, he inquired why Ram had to use monkeys to build the bridge to Lanka. He was a little proud. You know? He could have used arrows. Lord Ram could have made the bridge. A small monkey said that the bridge would break. You know that which monkey that was? Hanumanji. Arjuna said that he could make a bridge of arrows that no monkey could break. Again, haughtiness, little bit. Arrogance. The monkey challenged him. If Arjuna won the challenge, the monkey would become his servant. If the monkey won, then Arjuna would commit suicide because he's a Kshatriya. I cannot tolerate defeat. Arjuna made a bridge of arrows several times, but each time the monkey broke it. When Arjuna decided to commit suicide, a Brahmana boy appeared. Who's that Brahmana boy? Krishna. And said the contest should have an arbitrator. Arbitrator means who will mediator. Huh? Therefore, again the challenge was made. This time the monkey could not break it because now monkey was proud. He even expanded his form until it was huge, but still he could not break it. The monkey then realized that the Brahmana was his master and exclaimed, "Rama, Rama!" Arjuna recognized him as Krishna because they have different moods. Depending on their moods, they will recognize him. Krishna then advised them not to make contest like this. But reminded the monkey that he should fulfill his promise by placing himself on Arjuna's flag. So very beautiful story. So you know, first of all, one thing which Krishna does not like is competition between devotees. Devotees may be inspired to see other devotees serving, but one should not become proud. I am a very, very great person. And second thing, we learned how, this is the reason why Hanumanji blessed his presence on by being on the flag of Arjuna. You know what Hanumanji was doing? When there was fighting, while being on the flag of Arjuna, he will scream very loudly. So if he screams so loudly that the fellow who's fighting with him, he will become disturbed like this. So he was fighting. That's like this he was helping. Similarly, you also remember that Bhima also had requested one time. He was tested by Hanumanji, you know, the tail Leela. And then he was said, you please help us. He said, if I am there, then there is no fighting. If Hanumanji was fighting on the sides of Pandavas, there would have been no fun in the fighting. He would have just beaten everybody and finished. So he said, no, but I will be there in the form of a sign on the flag of Arjuna. And then same, I scream at the people and then that way shatter their hearts. So like this, purport. The battle was just about to begin. It is understood from the above statement that the son of Dhritarashtra were more or less disheartened by the unexpected arrangement of military force by the Pandavas, who were guided by the direct instruction of Lord Krishna on the battlefield. The emblem of Hanuman on the flag of Arjuna is another sign of victory, because Hanuman cooperated with Lord Ram in the battle between Ram and Ravan, and Lord Ram emerged victorious. So, just like Hanumanji was with Ramji, and Ram was victorious. Similarly, Kapidhvaja indicates that Hanumanji is on the side of Arjuna, so he'll become victorious. So you see, before the battle itself, there were signs that they were going to be victorious. Like yesterday, we had this transcendental conscience, you remember? That was a sign that they will be victorious. Now, both Ram and Hanuman were present on the chariot of Arjuna to help him. Lord Krishna is Ram himself, and wherever Lord Ram is, his eternal servitor Hanuman and his eternal consort Sita, the goddess of fortune, are present. Therefore, Arjuna had no cause to fear any enemies whatsoever. Did you notice this point? Krishna is there, so Lakshmi ji is also there. Lakshmi means tatra shir vijaya bhutir, not like that. There will be great power, there will be opulences. So naturally, Arjuna after the war will become opulent. So that is understood. If Krishna is there, then definitely Arjuna is going to win. Therefore, Arjuna had no cause to fear any enemies whatsoever. And above all, the Lord of the senses, Lord Krishna, was personally present to give him direction. That is indicated by the word Rishikesha. Thus, all good counsel was available to Arjuna in the matter of executing the battle. In such auspicious conditions, arranged by the Lord for his eternal devotee, lay the signs of assured victory. Beautiful point. Whenever a devotee is executing the will of the Lord, it may appear things are very, very difficult externally. But the Lord helps the devotee in ways which the devotee cannot understand and conceive. Are you able to understand this point? I give an example from the description of what is that? Churning of the milk ocean. So before the churning, the demigods were in a weak position, isn't it? So if they would have churned the ocean and they would have taken the, just one second. If they've taken out the Amrita, who would have taken the Amrit? Not the demigods, the demons, because they were already powerful. But still, because Lord Vishnu told them that you will get the nectar and not the demons, they had faith in the Lord and they execute the will of the Lord and they were helped at every step by the Lord. Understand my point? Similarly, in our own Krishna consciousness, we may feel, oh, this is very difficult. How am I going to purify my heart? How will I give? Whatever. How? But having this faith, Naam Sankirtan A Param Upaye. If I keep on chanting Hare Krishna mantra, all the earth anarthas will be destroyed. Naam Sankirtan Hate Haye Sarva Anarthashaye. By chanting of the holy names, all the anarthas will be destroyed. Having faith in the words of the Lord, if you keep on chanting Hare Krishna mantra, we'll see everything will be all right in the heart. We should have that kind of faith. Okay? Where we are. So by this, all the signs of victory were assured for Arjuna. Next, 21 to 23. Please chant after me. So what did Arjuna said?
Arjuna vacha.
Arjuna vacha.
Senayor ubhayor madhe.
Senayor ubhayor madhe.
Sthapyam echyuta.
Sthapatam echyuta.
Ratham sthapyame chuta.
Ratham sthapyame chuta.
Yavad etani riksheham.
Yavad etani riksheham.
Yodhakaman avasthitan.
Yodhakaman avasthitan.
Kairmaya sahayodhavyam.
Kairmaya sahayodhavyam.
Asmin rana samudhyame.
Asmin rana samudhyame.
Yotasya manana avik. Yotasya manana vekshaham.
Yotasya manana vekshaham.
Ya ete yatra samagataha.
Ya ete yatra samagataha.
Dhartarashtrasya durbuddhe.
Dhartarashtrasya durbuddhe.
Yudhe priya chikirshavaha.
Arjuna vacha means Arjuna said. Senayor ubhayor madhe. Ubhaya means both. So madhe means in between. So Ratham sthapya me chuta. The first is the meaning of the first line. O achyuta, O the Supreme Lord who never fails to show affection to his devotee. I'm your devotee. So now you please hear my words and do what I'm saying, because now the Lord has accepted the role of a charioteer of his devotee. So he won't say, no, I'll take the chariot as per my decision. No, no. Charioteer is under the instruction of the Rathi, Sarathi, or how do you call Rathi? The warrior, you can say the warrior. So then Lord is very nicely doing it. So he says, Senayor Abhayor Madhe, between the two armies, Senayor Abhayor Madhe, Ratham Sthapya Mechuta, O Achyuta, please placed my chariot. Is it clear, first line? Yeah. How long I should place your chariot? Yavad, as long as I, Etan Nirikshiham, Etan, all these people, both sides, nirikshaham, nirikshan matlab hota hai, nirikshan means to see, aham means I, as long as I am seeing both the parties, what kind of parties, yodhu kaman avasthitan, they have kaman means desire, they have come here to fight, avasthitan means they are very nicely situated, they are not fearful, they are not going to go back, so as long as I am going to examine or see both the parties, you please allow my ratha to be situated in between the two armies. Is it clear? Able to pick up the Sanskrit? Kair maya saha yodavyam. With whom I have to fight. Yodavya means I must fight now. What is with whom I have to fight? Asminarana samudhyame. In this udyam, you understand udyam means effort. Samudyam means nice effort. Asmin ran samudyame. In this efforts of fighting, I want to see whom I have to fight. Yotasya manana avikshiham. Those people who have come with a desire to fight with me, I want to see them. Avikshiham means same, iksha. I want to see them. Ya ete atra samagataha. All those people who have assembled here to fight with me. But why they have come here? Then he says, Dhartarashtrasya durbuddhe. Dhartarashtrasya means the son of Dhritarashtra, that means Duryodhan. What is his good quality? Durbuddhi. He has no buddhi, but he has buddhi, but durbuddhi, bad buddhi. He is tamas buddhi. He is not understanding. This all will bring his ruination. Yudhe Priya Chikrshiva, they are coming here to fight Priya Chikrshiva. They want to do good to the desire of Duryodhana. So with that desire, they are coming here to fight. So I want to see all those people who are following this foolish Duryodhana. Somehow I feel I go very fast, but I think you are able to pick up now. Translation, Arjuna said, O infallible one, please draw my chariot between the two armies so that I may see those present here who desire to fight and with whom I must contend in this great trial of arms. Let me see those who have come here to fight, wishing to please the evil-minded son of Dhritarashtra. Now, are you able to see that how Lord is inspiring Arjuna? If you know the pastime, Arjuna in the form of Vrihanala, Viranala was an inak. Inak, you understand? Between man and woman. For 1 year, he was cursed to be an inak. And at that time, the armies of Kurus had attacked Virat. Everybody has seen Mahabharata, you know that. So when at that time, Arjuna had fought with the same people. Bhishma, Drona. Drona was also there, I believe. Dronacharya, Karna. Everybody he fought alone. And he did not have any attachment. But now, suddenly, he has a desire. Oh, whom I have to fight now? So you see, all this is inspired by the Lord. It's not that Arjuna will get bewildered. He has already fought with them earlier, isn't it? Alone. So there is, first of all, there is no question of fear. There is no question of fear. And second is, can you imagine that actually? Alone fighting with Drona, Karna, everybody. And you know that Virat was, the son of Virat was first saying, I am a very great warrior. But I don't have anybody as a charioteer. Then Virhanala was there. Oh, this Inak. But then when he saw the armies, he was like terrified. He was running away. Then Arjuna captures him and puts him on the Ratha and brings his divine weapons and fights. Like that. So alone he fought with everybody. So there is no question of fear. And there is no question of giving up the Kshatriya duty. So we must understand this illusion was inspired by the will of the Lord. Otherwise, there is no possibility that Arjuna can be in any way be fearful or anything. There is no question of happening that. Okay. Oh, Achyuta, you do not deviate from your innate nature. Beautiful points. From your affection for your devotee or from your supreme power. Beautiful point. Beautiful point. This is one of the beautiful purports Srila Prabhupada is writing. Beautiful purports. Sorry, this is Gita Bhushan and then Prabhupada also refers to in his purports. What is the meaning of Achyuta? Achyuta means to fall off. Achyuta means who does not fall. So what does Lord does not fall from? From his promise, from his quality of being merciful to his devotees. This is a beautiful point, beautiful point. It's not that Krishna is not merciful to any of his devotees. It's not that somebody is serving Krishna and Krishna will not show mercy to him. It is impossible. It's not, never ever it has happened that somebody has served Krishna and Krishna has not shown mercy to him. It has never ever, eternally, never happened. Another meaning of Achyuta is that anybody from the family of Krishna never falls here. Two people came, Jay and Vijay came here and Krishna came personally from the spiritual world to deliver them three times. Isn't it? Jay Vijay came and then we came as Varahadev, we came as Lord Ram and then Lord Krishna. So his servants can never fall from, he's never fall. And then he's also, Prabhupada says, he's never falls from his quality of showing affection to his devotee. His devotee Arjuna has surrendered himself to Krishna and Krishna also is now ready to become a charioteer for him. And then also supreme power. There is no time that Krishna's power can be diminished by anything for that matter. This is a very nice word. This will come so many times in Srimad Bhagavatam. Achyuta, 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 like this. Controlled by this quality without fear. This is a life-giving word for us, life-giving name of Krishna for us, because sometimes in a lot of difficulty in our life, we may think, oh, Krishna is not showing mercy, Krishna is becoming indifferent to me, but Krishna has never become indifferent to anybody for that matter. He was not even indifferent to a Jamil for that matter. How can he be indifferent to a devotee who surrendered his life for him? Very beautiful point for the Brahmacharis specifically. Lord Vishnu says to Durvasa, those who have given up their families and surrendered everything for me, how can I give them up, O Durvasa? This is a very heart-touching point. Isn't it? Controlled by this quality without fear, place my chariot according to my words, the words of your devotee. Because you are affectionate to your devotee, so you fulfill the words of your devotee. Britya Bhashitam. So it will come in Bhagavatam also. What is that? Nijabritya Bhashitam, that Lord came as Narsingh Dev to fulfill the desires or to fulfill the words of Brahmaji of Hiranyakashipu, because he was also the son, he was also the servant of the Lord, and Prahlad Maharaj and four Kumars, like this. So Lord is very much eager. In Chaitanya Charitamrita is mentioned, Lord is only business of the Lord is to fulfill the desires of his Vritya or servant. And that's why Srila Prabhupada said, 16 rounds, four regular principles, you go back to Godhead in this life. Prabhupada will, Krishna will fulfill the words of Srila Prabhupada. There should be no doubt about it. That's why the first, Prabhupada said, first duty of the spiritual, first instruction of the spiritual master is to chant 16 rounds. He very explicitly mentions, secure your place, secure your ticket going back home, back to Godhead by chanting Hare Krishna very nicely. In all my preaching, this is my emphasis. First get a 16 rounds done nicely. You fulfill the words of Acharya and then see how Krishna will take you care of us. Everything will be okay. He then speaks of the purpose for doing so. That means, why should the Lord put his chariot between the two armies? Place the chariot so that I can see who are situated firmly, not trembling in fear, and are desirous of fighting with no desire for compromise. So you understand this point? I want to see who are very eager for fighting. That's the point being mentioned here. But you are a fighter. I have made it in a red so that in case Krishna answers, raises a question to Arjuna's argument. So that is in red. But you are a fighter, not a spectator. What will be accomplished by viewing this? This is quite interesting. You see, like if two parties are fighting, that's all right. But there can be some people who are looking at the fight, just like this WWF fight, isn't it? So two fighters are fighting, not everybody is fighting. So others are, more people are spectators, isn't it? They will say, ah, why? So they are fighting like this. So they are looking it. So what do you mean to say by the point that you want to look? You're not a spectator, you're going to fight, isn't it? What do you want to look now here? The sound of the conch shell has been blown. So what is the point you want to see? So if Krishna asks this question, so then Arjuna answers, I wish to see at the beginning of the battle those friends and relatives in those in whose company I will fight, and those friends and relatives against whom I will fight. Now how, just think about it, how this commentary is derived. As far as I can understand, senayor bhayor madhye, he's exactly situated between the two armies. Can you put yourself in the shoes of Arjuna for a few minutes? He is right now in the center of both the armies, so to speak, and he can see both very clearly. They can see the faces. Bhishma Dev, whom he was actually referring to as father. And Bhishma Dev says, no, I'm not your father, I'm your grandfather. He was so affectionate to Bhishma Dev. Are you able to understand? Can you imagine what I'm trying to say? Arjuna is in between both the armies. So he's seeing, oh, these people I'm going to fight along with. And these people are the people who I'm going to fight with. But they are both my relatives. So now some illusion will come inside. Some attachment will come inside. Okay. You must understand also, Arjuna means he was very soft-hearted. Raju, it is derived from the word Raju. He's very soft-hearted, very simple-hearted, very soft-hearted. Although he was a warrior, but he was very respectful, very nice. He was always remembering the favors of his spiritual masters like Dronacharya, Kripacharya. It was not like Duryodhana. So you see, he was a very soft-natured person, which Srila Prabhupada will discuss in the purport. For that purpose, that means for looking at both of them, place my chariot between the two armies. Out of friendship, they will make peace. If Krishna says this, do you think they're going to make peace? No. There will be no conciliation between the two sides. This is a very interesting way of putting the commentary. I believe that they are intent on fighting. That means yosyamananan. They are intent on fighting, desiring to please the son of Dhritarashtra, who is unintelligent, durbuddhe, ignorant of the means for his own survival, ignorant that he is going to die, even in the face of this war, which does not sober his intelligence. Therefore, my viewing the rival party in war is justified. So you see that he just want to, right now he is thinking, I am just going to see who are the people who want to fight. He is not thinking that suddenly some affection or attachment will come in his heart. That is Lord's arrangement. And why he's referring to Duryodhana as Durbuddhi? Very simple. Lord Krishna came as mediator? Mediator? Peacemaker? And he said, these Pandavas are Kshatriyas. They are not Brahmanas. So you give them five villages and they will be happy. But he could not accept the instructions of Lord Krishna. What did he say? Without war, I will not give even earth which is equal to the measurement of the tip of a pin. You must have heard this, no? So then he could not accept the words of Krishna. Then said, okay, then fight and you will be destroyed. This is the Durbuddhi, Parpada Srila Prabhupada. Although Lord Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, out of his causeless mercy, he was engaged in the service of his friend. Nobody can be an instructor of Krishna, but Krishna naturally becomes happy to serve his devotee. He never fails in his affection for his devotees, and thus he is addressed herein as infallible. It's a beautiful point. Again, as I was referring to, Krishna's affection can come in the form of distress. It will come in the form of happiness. But in both cases, in a devotee's life, Krishna's affection is only coming. It has to be understood. We can't understand immediately, but that is a version of Shastra. Anybody who chants Hare Krishna, Krishna thinks, I must protect this devotee. Protection can be in many ways. Sometimes the mother gives a slap also and protects, isn't it? If the child is touching fire or child is touching, knife, the mother will give a slap. So, you understand my point? So this is how the Lord is never ever, this is a beautiful quality of the Lord. We should always look and remember, Krishna will always give me mercy. Always give me mercy. As charioteer, he had to carry out the orders of Arjuna. And since he did not hesitate to do so, he is addressed as infallible. You understand this point? If you tell a servant, do this, and he does not do, then say, what is this? But Achyuta means when he is acting as a charioteer for his devotee, he will act as a perfect charioteer. If he act as a son for his devotee, he will act as a perfect son. And if you want to become his enemy, then he will become a perfect enemy also. Enemy means he'll behave as a perfect enemy. Although he had accepted the position of a charioteer for his devotee, his supreme position was not challenged. A beautiful example given by His Holiness Radha Govind Maharaj, that there is crow and there is Garuda. You understand crow and Garuda? Yeah. Garuda is a carrier of Lord Vishnu. So suppose there is Mount Meru. Mount Meru is very, very big. So if the crow is sitting on top of Mount Meru and Garuda is sitting at the bottom, it doesn't mean the crow is better than Garuda. Are you able to understand the example? Similarly, if Krishna is acting as a charioteer, still he is a master. That's the whole point. It doesn't make him lesser just because he's accepting a lower position in this world. Just like you know that Yudhishthira Maharaj, Rasi Yogya, he took up the service of accepting the shoes of everybody like that. It doesn't make him down or something. Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead. I am surprised how Yudhishthira Maharaj could allow him to do that. You know, allow Krishna to accept the shoes or wash the feet of everyone who comes there. That's amazing. Will be real fun when we meet Krishna one day, isn't it? What do you think, Kunal? Krishna is very nice. We'll ask all the questions from him. Krishna, why you did like this? Krishna, why you did like this? Krishna, why this? And it's a reality. One day we will meet Krishna. One time, Rompad Maharaj very nicely mentions, beautiful. Muchukund Maharaj was told by Gargacharya, one day you will see Krishna. Beautiful. And he actually saw Krishna, even while he was sleeping. So then Rompad Maharaj was mentioning, His Holiness Maharaji, that once you see Krishna, then you don't ask him anything material. Yes, I want your love for your feet. This is a reality. In all circumstances, he is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Rishikesha, the Lord of the total senses. That means even he is acting as a charioteer, he is guiding the senses of Arjuna nonetheless. The relationship between the Lord and his servitor is very sweet and transcendental. Beautiful point. Amazing. This is the point I want to emphasize in now. The servitor is always ready to render service to the Lord. And similarly, the Lord is always seeking an opportunity to render some service to the devotee. What is that shloka? Ye tham mam prapadyante tam satev bhajamyaham. Just like a devotee wants to glorify Krishna, Krishna wants to glorify his devotee. Prabhupada wanted to glorify Krishna, Prabhupada is glorified all over the world. Is it not? Similarly, I want to say this, I have not told you this pastime. When, you know the one part of the pastime, but Arjuna and Duryodhana had approached Krishna to seek help. You know that. And Arjuna was first seen by Krishna. So Krishna said, Arjuna is younger and I first saw Arjuna, so let him get the chance. And you know, he has told that I will not fight, and there will be one Akshahani Narayani Sena of mine, so you can choose between the two. And Arjuna said, okay, my lord, I want you. So after that, Duryodhana said, okay, no problem, Dwarkadhish, I'm okay. Send your army to me, I'm happy. But then Krishna asked Arjuna, are you fool? I'm not going to fight. Why you chose me? Does somebody know what was Arjuna's reply? This is one of the most emotional things. I've tried not to become emotional. But he said that, my lord, there was a desire in my heart that my life, the reins of my life, right? Reins, you understand this? Rasiya. The reins of my life, I want to hand over to you. So you please become my charioteer. Then Krishna came into a full avesh. He said, even if Arjuna, the three worlds are against fighting you, they cannot defeat you. You see the surrender of Arjuna? You try to put yourself in that situation. So devotee surrender to Krishna. So Krishna also accepts the devotee in that way. The Arjuna want to serve the cause of the Lord in any way possible. Prabhupada says, because the Pandavas were malleable in the service of the Lord. Malleable, you understand? You beat the metal in any shape you form you desire. Similarly, because the Pandavas never complain and they want to be an instrument of service of the Lord in any way. So Krishna also reciprocated in that way. Both from both sides, there is eagerness to serve each other. Very beautiful relationship. In this world, the person whom I am serving, he does not want to serve me. He just want to extract as much juice he can extract before he can throw me away. Yes? That's why people do not want to accept eternal servitorship, because they have a very bad experience of master in this world. But master, isn't it? But Krishna is not like that master. He takes great pleasure in his pure devotees assuming the advantageous position of ordering him than he does in being the giver of orders. Since he's a master, everyone is under his orders and no one is above him to order him. But when he finds that a pure devotee is ordering him, he obtains transcendental pleasure, although he is the infallible master in all circumstances. You understand? From the point of view of Siddhanta, Krishna is always master. But the point of view of Rasa, he derives special pleasure when a devotee will chastise him. Why are you not eating Nimai? Like Sachi Mata will say, what is this you are doing? And then Jagannath Mishra is running after Nimai Pandit with a stick. What is this? This child has become very, very, naughty. I'll beat him up now. And Nimai runs very nicely. He could not catch him. And in the dream, when Brahmana comes in the dream of Jagannath Mishra. Are Baba, you understand his absolute truth, his Krishna. Then in the dream only Jagannath Mishra is saying, he may be God, but it is my duty as a father to correct him. So it does not, it's like this. So Krishna likes that, isn't it? And I've shown the photo here. You see, this child is on the shoulder of his father. And very easily, you see, the feet is touching the chest of the father, but the father is very happy. So who is the father? In this photo, father is father and the child is child. Just because child is on the shoulder of father does not mean the child becomes a father. But father takes special pleasure, is it not? Yes, okay. Prabhupada gave the example. He gave example of Winston Churchill. At the time of World War, he was a very powerful man. He was the Prime Minister of England. So one time, one fellow wanted to meet Mr. Winston Churchill, and then the secretary told that he's very busy. He's in a meeting. So that long time passed, and then he said, "What meeting he's in? With whom he's meeting?" So with the keyhole, he saw this. Winston Churchill had become ghoda, horse, and his grandson was saying, "Oh my horse, go very fast! Oh my horse, go very fast!" He's still a very powerful person. But he wants to have that reciprocation of affection from his grandchild. You understand this point? So this is a point being illustrated. Why the Lord becomes a child and why he becomes a charioteer of his devotees like this. You know, this beautiful. I like this photo so much. You see, child Krishna, very beautifully decorated. And he's carrying the shoes of Nanda Maharaj. Can you imagine? Whose lotus feet are being sought by great sages. He is carrying the shoes of Nanda Maharaj. Tamaham Nandam Vande Yasya Alinde Param Brahma. People can read Mahabharata if they are fearful of the samsara. But as far as we are concerned, who is that? Raghupati Upadhyaya says, as far as we are concerned, we will worship Nanda Maharaj in his angan, in whose angan Parabrahma, Krishna is playing. This is a beautiful photo. So the same point, Krishna is very happy to carry the sandals. Sandals, not khadam, khadam of Nanda Maharaj, because they have such a beautiful, unceasing, pure love for Lord Krishna. Like this. So you understand? And one more example I was able to give. I forgot. Okay. As a pure devotee of the Lord, Arjuna had no desire to fight with his cousins. But he was forced to come onto the battlefield by the obstinacy of Duryodhan, who was never agreeable to any peaceful negotiation. That we have discussed above. So that he could have agreed to the five villages, but he could not. That's why he was Durbuddhi. Therefore, he was very anxious to see who the leading persons present on the battlefield were. Therefore, you understand, he is in a mood now. What is this foolish Duryodhan? Because of this, now all these people will be killed from my side and from the other side also. Although there was no question of a peacemaking endeavor on the battlefield, he wanted to see them again and to see how much they were bent upon demanding on an unwanted war. Can you enter into the consciousness of Arjuna? Arjuna does not want war. Still, he does not want war. But he's just looking at it, and why these people want to fight a war like this? It was an open secret that Duryodhan wanted to usurp the kingdom of the Pandavas by evil plans in collaboration with his father Dhritarashtra. Therefore, all persons who had joined the side of Duryodhan must have been birds of the same feather. You understand this point? Birds of the same feather means having same mentality. Because Duryodhan was like that, so all these people would have been also like that who want to usurp the kingdom. Arjuna wanted to see them on the battlefield before the fight was begun, just to learn who they were, but he had no intention of proposing peace negotiations with them. This we have discussed in the commentary. It was also a fact that he wanted to see them to make an estimate of the strength which he had to face, although he was quite confident of victory because Krishna was sitting by his side. So he was not fearful, but he wanted to make an estimation of who the people were fighting. But the main point which I learned from this shloka was Achyuta. How Krishna is never giving up his quality of showing mercy to his devotees. This is not only for Arjuna, but for all the devotees eternally. Krishna is this very, very nice quality. Seeing this quality, a devotee lives. Okay, any questions are there? I don't know if there are questions on Zoom or something. Let me just check for a second. Whenever I attend your lecture, I feel very distressed, because I am not able to invite people in your lecture. I invite many times, but they hardly come. That's why sometimes I feel very distressed. It's okay. Be happy in hearing and chanting. What to do? People are... It's not a difficult thing when Krishna says, what is it? Manushanam sahasreshu. Out of thousands of people, one will become interested in spiritual life. So how many people are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 15. 15, including myself. 15,000 people are hearing. Just like in IIT, there's a lot of filtration, isn't it? 5 lakh and how much? 3-4,000 rupees, 3-4,000 people get selected. Also, Prabhupada gives a very nice example. Just because in a PhD class, PhD, you understand? Permanent head damage. In a PhD class, there are few students. Does not mean that the PhD course is not run. Make sense? Similarly, Bhagavad Gita is a great spiritual science. Bhagavatam is more deep. So it does not mean that we stop giving pravachana, stop discussion. We derive nutrition from this. And if some others are interested, that's good. Any other questions? I don't know whether it's on something or that. Okay, so we shall stop here. Thank you all so much for coming. Srimad Bhagavad Gita ki jai. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.